Now we'll consider why the divider-chooser method of fair division is not appropriate for more than two people. So we'll begin by defining the divisor-chooser method and then provide an example for why the divider-chooser method is meant for only two players. To apply the divisor-chooser method, we have a divider and a chooser. The divider cuts the item into two pieces that are, in the player's opinion, equal in value. And then step two, the chooser selects either of the two pieces, and then step three, the divider receives the remaining piece. So again, this method is meant for only two players. But let's see what can happen if we try to apply this method to a group of three players. Three investors are dividing a piece of land worth $300,000. Each investor's value in thousands for each of the three pieces of land is shown below. So for example, Juan values piece one at $80,000, piece two at $100,000, and piece three at $120,000. Notice each row would have a sum of $300,000, the value of all of the land. Also notice Linda would be the divider because notice how she's valuing each piece of land the same at $100,000, which is her job as the divider. Let's say that Juan chooses first. Well, he would select piece three, which he values at $120,000. And because each person's fair share would be $100,000, a third of the total value, he receives a fair share. Notice it doesn't matter which piece Linda takes, she will always receive a fair share at $100,000. Let's say she selects piece two. Notice this leaves Martin with piece one, which he only values at $60,000, and therefore Martin does not receive a fair share. So this is the reason why the divisor chooser method would not be guaranteed to provide each player with a fair share unless there are only two players. So once again, divider chooser can only be used with two players to assure each person receives a fair share. I hope you found this helpful.